In this demo, we will demonstrate AED's hybrid DDoS protection. Netskout's Arbor DDoS protection solution starts with Arbor Edge Defense on the premise. Arbor Edge Defense is a stateless packet processing device that can stop all types of DDoS attacks, but it specifically excels at stopping application layer and state exhaustion attacks. In the event of a large bandwidth consuming attack, for example, that will consume the internet facing pipe, there is a feature called cloud signaling in AED, which reroutes attack traffic to a cloud-based mitigation service, either from your ISP or our own Arbor Cloud service, which has over 14 scrubbing centers, 11 terabits of mitigation capacity located throughout the world. It is this combination of on-premise and cloud-based mitigation, which is called hybrid defense, and this is the most comprehensive form of DDoS attack protection. So here's our demo scenario. We have a fictitious application called Arbor Trade running, and you'll notice it kind of blinking, indicating that it's active. We have an on-premise environment that has a 10 meg internet pipe. Small, but it's enough for our demonstration today. And then we have an attacker who's going to launch a series of attacks against or targeting the Arbor Trade application. The attacker will start out with an attack that's smaller than a 10 meg pipe, therefore it flows through the pipe and will be mitigated with the Arbor Edge Defense device. After this, the attacker will launch a much larger attack, 300 megabits per second, big enough to saturate that 10 megabits per second pipe, in which case the cloud signaling feature in Arbor Edge Defense will reroute that attack traffic to an Arbor Cloud scrubbing center. So let's get started with our demonstration. Imagine this. You arrive at your desk in the morning, and lo and behold, you notice a DDoS attack occurred over the night. You didn't even know about it. Let's check it out. So what we have here is the Arbor Edge Defense main screen or dashboard. Now the blue traffic that you're seeing here is total amount of traffic that was traversing the AED. And you see it was almost pegged at about 8.5 meg of total traffic for a sustained period of time. Looks like about, you know, and then it dropped off here at, we'll say, 12:15 in the morning. What you see on this screen are things like web servers, DNS servers, file servers, and these are the protection groups or devices that AED is actually protecting. We're concerned about the Arbor Trade application. So let's go and check on it real quick, to making sure it's still up. Yes, it is. It's blinking away as we would expect it to, or hope it would be. But now let's drill into this a little bit further. What we noticed on here in this section is that behind this web server, which is running the application that we're concerned about, we see that there was almost eight meg of total traffic. 4 meg legitimate traffic, as you see in green here, or passed, and almost another 4 meg blocked, or illegitimate, or attack traffic, as you see here in red. So this was happening automatically by the Arbor Edge device, unbeknownst to you, until you came in the next day and saw this on the dashboard. So, you know, potentially, you dodged a bullet here. The Arbor Edge defense did exactly what it was supposed to do, that it was to stop an inbound DDoS attack. This is the value of having Arbor Edge defense on-premise. Stop those smaller attacks that will fly through your internet pipe. They're not big enough to saturate that pipe, but you still want some protection on premise. Now we can drill into this a little bit further and get more information about the actual tap. Here we see it was a UDP flood. That's predominantly what it was. We can see here it was actually coming from multiple sources around the globe, so that you can almost know then that it's a truly a distributed denial of service attack, probably from a botnet. Here you see that it was coming from various countries around the world. And, you know, it was really utilizing TCP and UDP traffic. See some services and so on. Now, you realize, whoa, my pipe was only 10 meg. What if the attacker comes back with a larger attack? Well, unfortunately, the attackers know when they are mitigating or being mitigated. And as you're seeing here, here's a DDoS attack tool. And it's as easily done as this. It's a simply a click of a button that an attacker can launch any type of DDoS attack. In this case, I'm going to take those same attacks and just increase the attack size. We're going to increase the size of our packet from 64 to 1500 bytes. The point is that it is truly this easy for an attacker to launch an attack. It's simply a change of a few parameters, a click of a button, and they can do exactly this. Now in our scenario, the pipe is saturated. The attacker has launched a much larger attack that is larger than our 10 gig or 10 megabits per second pipe. And then when we try to refresh our ArborTrade application, it's down. And what we see here is this little increase in traffic that went from 8 to 10. Now it's maxed out at 10, meaning the Arbor Edge Defense device is sitting on-prem. It is behind a 10 meg circuit. That means this the maximum amount of traffic that can come in. So the Arbor Edge Defense device just sees 10 meg, but it could be much larger than that. So now what we're going to do is initiate what's called the cloud signal. Now, Arbor Edge Defense can be configured to do this automatically. For example, when I see an attack that comes within 90% of filling my internet pipe, which you configure the Arbor Edge Defense to know this, I want you to initiate a cloud signaling or cloud signal to my upstream ISP, or in this case, it's going to our Arbor Cloud account. So this is all pre-established or pre-configured in the event of this large attack. But for demo purposes, we're just going to do it here manually. So we activate Arbor Cloud, and what that's doing is actually sending a signal upstream to a predetermined site. And in fact, here is what it looks like in the in this case, the Arbor Cloud Security Operations Center. An Arbor Cloud is received. The message is received within the user interface on the dashboard. As you can see here, it was an alert coming from an AED device that's requesting mitigation. So there's more than just a call for help. There's actually a lot of information about the attack itself. Where is it coming from? What protocols is it using, etc. And in this case, the Arbor Cloud service is actually running another product from Arbor Network called Sightline and potentially the TMS application, Threat Management System. And it's going to automatically take that information from the Arbor Cloud notice and start a mitigation effort. So if we click on that, what you're presented with is the mitigation screen. Now, again, this is all happening up in the cloud somewhere. In fact, many of the ISPs of the world run this same product called the Arbor Sightline product, and it will be actually executing exactly this. So there's a intelligent level of communication between the Arbor Edge Defense on-premise and the Arbor Sightline and TMS products up in the cloud. But what we see here in this red area here is that it is, in fact, much larger than a 10 meg pipe. It is up over 300 megabits per second. So that's why our pipe was so saturated. So what we can do here is start the mitigation effort up in the cloud, which it did automatically. But now what you see is this little bit of a drop off now. This is just the tail end of this attack, which means that the attack traffic is now being mitigated up in the cloud. In Arbor Edge Defense, back on the premise, see the drop off of this attack traffic, which was much higher than 10 meg, was up over 300 megabits per second. We do a quick refresh on our Arbitrate application, and lo and behold, it's back up. It's not because AED is mitigating attack, it's because the attack has been mitigated upstream in the Arbor Cloud service or the ISP service, demonstrating the hybrid approach. Started with a smaller attack of AED on-premise and then ended with a mitigation of a much larger attack up in the premise itself. And there it is, it's still running. And there's the drop-off in traffic, as we were telling you. So that concludes our demonstration of NetScout Arbor's hybrid DDoS attack protection solution. Starting with Arbor Edge Defense on the premise to stop those smaller attacks, having the ability to automatically cloud signal upstream to an ISP or an Arbor Cloud service for the much larger attacks. Hybrid DDoS defense is the most comprehensive form of attack protection. Thank you for watching our demonstration.